Hi, Horror Recapped here. Today, I am going to be covering an American thriller film, Run. Spoilers incoming. Watch out and take care. The film begins with Diane Sherman at the hospital. She delivered a baby, who was malnourished and premature. She is seen praying and is wheeled to her baby. She asks if her baby will be okay. In the next scene, they explain to us some chronic diseases such as asthma, diabetes and paralysis. The story fast forwards to 18 years and here we see Diane Sherman sitting with some people, attending a monthly parents' meeting, where she is describing her sentiments for sending Chloe to a college. She says that she is totally fine and is not worried at all because Chloe is smart, brave and capable. Diane was homeschooling her daughter Chloe. She was suffering from all those severe diseases, which were explained to us previously in a scene. Chloe was in a wheelchair and was taking heavy medication. She enjoys being homeschooled and was interested in science and technology. She wanted to go and attend the University of Washington, but she hasn't heard back from them. One day, Chloe was working on her classwork and heard a noise outside. Thinking it was the mail truck, she went to see. It was her mom. Her mom dropped off her groceries in the kitchen and went out to take a call. Chloe wanted to eat some chocolate, so she went to take some from the grocery bag. In there, she found some green and gray capsules with her mom's name written on them. At night, Diane says to Chloe that her medicines were changed by her doctor and now she'll be taking the new medicines. But Chloe asked her, thinking that it was her mother's medicine because she saw her name on the jar. Diane said that her name was on the receipt and was not prescribed to her. Chloe doubted her mom but reluctantly took the medicine. The next morning, Chloe went to examine the tablets. The tablets were trigoxin and had her name on them. But she peeled back the description sticker to reveal her mom's name on them. At night, she faked taking the medicine, spitting out the medicine after her mom leaves the room. Late at night, she wanted to search the name on Google to know more about the medicine. She sneakily went downstairs and reached the computer. But unfortunately, she wasn't able to access the internet. In the background, we see Diane keeping a close eye on her. As her mother is out in the garden watering the crops, she called Pasco Pharmacy twice but could not find any information. Then, she called a random number and there a man picked her call, who was yelling at his girlfriend. Chloe requested him to Google the medicine name. The person did and angrily told her that trigoxin is a red color pill used to treat severe heart failure. Chloe was really disturbed by this fact. During dinner, Chloe asked if they could go and watch a movie together in the theater the following day and they both went. Chloe said that she needed to go to the bathroom but she actually went to the pharmacy to ask about the medicine. She asked the pharmacist what that medicine was for but the pharmacist said she could not tell her since it was issued under her mom's name. Chloe told her that she was playing a game and that the medicine was one of the clues. Pharmacist agreed to tell her but was confused since the medicine were for dogs, not humans. She said it was ridocaine, which was a leg muscle relaxer for dogs. Chloe was shocked and abruptly asked what would happen if a human had consumed it. The pharmacist said humans' legs would be numb. Diane got to Chloe in the pharmacy, told everyone to move away and gave Chloe a sedative injection. Chloe passes out. Diane locked Chloe in her room as she panics with what to do next. She writes an angry email to her family doctor but decided not to send it. After this, she searched on Google household neurotoxins and went out to buy some. Chloe tried to picklock the door open but with her mother anticipating this, she locked the door with a broomstick from outside. Chloe thought of another way to break out. She took a solder, a towel and a mouthful of water. She jumped out onto the roof and went to the window of another room. She broke the window with the solder and water, and got in safely with her towel to avoid the shattered glass. She got her inhaler and relaxed. Then, she moved towards the stairs but she was unable to go down so she pushed herself from the stairs and it hurt her back. This was the first time she was able to move anything from her waist down. Finally, she went out and met with Tom who was en route to deliver mail and packages. He got out of his truck to make sure she is okay. She tells what has been happening. He agreed to get Diane out of there but as he wheels her to the back of the mail truck, Diane pulled up and saw Tom and her daughter. She confronted him but after a brief argument, she agreed to have Tom drive Chloe to the hospital. Tom was relieved and put Chloe in the back of the van, planning to bring her to the police. As his back was turned to Diane, she is seen pulling out a needle. She came up behind him and gave him a sedative injection. Chloe's heart starts to race. She took Chloe and locked her in the basement. As she was there, Chloe found the dark secrets of Diane. She found that she was not the biological daughter of Diane. Turns out, Diane kidnapped her from the hospital because her own baby had died. Chloe also found a picture of her childhood, where her legs were working. She got a picture of her biological parents from a newspaper cut, who were searching for their daughter. Diane comes home with the ingredients and after dealing with Tom. Chloe confronted Diane about all this matter. Diane insisted that she had taken care of Chloe and was a very good mother. After this, she poured some paint thinner into the pot, mixed it and added it into a needle to inject Chloe. Before Diane got to her, Chloe locked herself by crawling into the closet and drank a poisonous drink or chemical. She did it to get out of her house. To save Chloe's life, Diane had to take her to the hospital. The doctors called it a suicide attempt and wanted to keep her under observation for several days. As she was in the hospital, Chloe writes the word mom on a page, but an emergency in the hospital pulls the nurse away from the room. Diane kidnaps her and ties her to the wheelchair. Chloe tried to tell the others that she was being kidnapped, but no one noticed. As they reached the stairs, she was unable to take her down since the escalators weren't working. Eventually, the cops rushed in and shot Diane. 7 years have passed and Chloe is married, has a baby named Annie and is working as a doctor. She has also found her real parents. Chloe visits Diane and forcefully makes Diane take the green and gray tablets. She wants Diane to be paralyzed out of revenge, just like what Diane had done to her. Subscribe for more videos like this one. Turn on notifications. Leave a like to help the channel out. Comment down what you thought about Diane's character.